Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how I build this rotating camera mount. In the past year, I've been using this DIY mount for recording with very limited angles available. I've come up with a better idea, and today I'm going to build a rotating arm for my workshop. I started off with cutting the four arms for the mount. The length is a personal preference, it can be longer for taller ceilings, mine are 50 cm long arms. Then I cut two pieces of 1x1 timber for spacers between the arms. I added another piece of wood between, so the arms won't interfere while rotating. You will see in a bit what I mean. I glued and clamped these together and waited for the glue to set. Meanwhile, I rounded one end of all four arms on my jigsaw table. I sanded them, then I drilled holes into the rounded ends for the bolts. I used 10mm bolts, but 8mm will do the job as well. I cut a spacer and glued it to the other end of one arm. When dried, I pushed the bolt through the hole, I made sure that the arms are parallel to each other, then I glued the other arm to the spacer. When the large spacer dried, I glued the other set of arms to it in the same way, while making sure that there is enough space to attach the other arm to it later on. I cut out a piece of plywood, this will be the holding plate for my camera ball head. I marked where the ball head is going to be placed and I made sure that it's a bit further away from the spacer. I glued it to the end of the arm, including the spacer. I clamped this arm to the other one and using the existing hole, I drilled through with a 10mm drill bit. Then I cut one last spacer for the top of the mount. In the same way, I clamped it to its place and drilled through the existing hole for the bolt. While I was doing this, the glue let go of the ball head plate, so I added a new layer of glue and a couple of screws to secure it. I disassembled the arm and I cut off a piece from the large spacer in a 45 degrees angle to be able to fit the spring. I marked and drilled a hole for the bolt that will hold the spring in position. To mark the other end, I placed the bolt with the spring into the hole. This spring is really strong, so I ended up drilling another hole closer to the spacer later on. The next step was to build something that will hold the spring on the top of the mount and to attach the mount onto the ceiling of the shed. I came up with the idea of cutting two arms in a 45 degrees angle. I glued and screwed them to the spacer on the top of the mount. Then I cut out two pieces of wood and attached to each side of the mount, a little bit further from one end. This will give me enough space to drill a hole for the bolt to hold the spring. Then I cut a small platform and drilled a hole in the middle for a bolt. This will hold the entire mount and will allow me to rotate the mount freely. Now I could drill a hole for the bolt that will hold the spring. The same way I did on the other end, I marked where I needed to drill the hole. Finally, I could assemble the mount for the last time. Now that the mount was ready, I built a small platform, which I attached to the top of the shed. Using as many screws as possible, I attached this mount to the top of the shed, and I was finally able to place the mount to its final place. I did not like those wing nuts on the arms, so I decided to build my own knobs out of wood and a couple of threaded inserts. I used my jigsaw to roughly cut the circles, then I drilled holes into all of them. I placed threaded inserts in two of them, then I put all through a long bolt. This allowed me to place it in my drill. I turned it on and using a sandpaper, I sanded them to the same size and shape. I drilled the correct size for the holes, glued them together and placed the inserts into them. When dried, I marked and cut out a triangle shape from four corners. Lastly, I sanded the rough edges and it was all done. Thank you for watching and please subscribe to the channel if you like the content. Give us a like, comment and share our videos to help the channel grow.